Man, every time I look at this thing, it is just so ugly and so mangled. My goodness. So, getting ready to take this thing off of our Mercury here, the Marquis. Getting ready to put this thing in storage for winter. Trailer racing season is over. Got a couple ideas of what we want to do with this car, hopefully to get the steering reinforced for next trailer race. Now, that seems to be the biggest problem with this thing. Hitch design obviously is working. After the abuse we've put it through in two races, the hitch has not come apart. It's even twisted itself on the ball and still managed to hold on, just barely. So I've come to realize something now after thinking about trailer races in general and a lot of the damage and carnage that goes through these things. So a lot of people run this trailer race, and when it's all over, if their trailer rips off, or when they're done, they just don't want to bring the trailer home, they disconnect it, they leave them in a big old pile at the racetrack. They just toss them for scrap or whatever the case. But the derby driver mindset of me always wants to hoard all the parts that you can, because that's what you do when you derby cars. You keep all the extra parts, so when you build your next car, you got stuff that you could be interchanged or swapped out that you don't have to pay money for. Now, in my mind, if I'm going to do trailer races for a long term, or if anybody is, it makes the most sense to me to salvage all the parts we can off every single trailer that we race. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. This trailer's junk. It's pretty much not going to be usable for another race. Technically, I could pull it still. I could cut the back, shove the back in the air a little bit up, leave it as is, and pull it. But with the damage to the frame structure, I'm pretty certain I could keep it on the hitch. I can remount it, chain it down. You can do almost anything you want to attach these trailers to the vehicles. That's not the problem. The issue is going to be this actual frame just separating itself from the hitch. All I'm going to have left is a little bit of a tongue, and everything else will be gone off of this. And the rules, they're a little bit tricky to decipher when it comes down to what is considered a trailer at the end of a race. You must have a long enough piece of your trailer still attached to the tongue coming off back down here to be considered still a trailer. So if enough of this were to snap off, even though it's still attached up there, you could still be eliminated from the race and it would not count as a qualifying finish for whatever placement you get. You must have an actual item still being pulled behind you. A lot of that is up for debate still. After this last race, we had a person finish top three that had very little left on the back of their trailer. It could have been argued. I personally wasn't going to argue it because I don't care. I'm not doing this for the money or for placing in the top three. Whatever, I'm here to have a fun time. But if people do competitively want to start doing trailer racing, I could see where they're going to have to get an exact measurement of a length to decide what that qualifies for, or some case is going to have to be put into the rules. That'll be decided maybe for the 2021 season. So instead, what I'm going to do is we're going to hack apart this trailer and keep everything we can that's salvageable, which in my mind is everything right here in the middle. I want to keep this entire axle, the leaf springs, I'll chop off the back here. I will keep this C-channel piece right here that has the leaf spring brackets already attached to it. There's another piece of, looks like almost building girts, just a Z-girt, a Z-bracket right here in the middle that also has these attached to it. I'll keep both of those and probably this cross runner so I can just roll them around in this middle section on the wheels. They're usable still. This wheel's junk. That wheel's still holding air, so it's worth keeping. And then I will probably cut the A-frame maybe right around where that angle iron is and just kind of hack it right there and hack it right there so I have this tongue essentially. That's the way if I find another trailer cheap or any other thing in the future, I can always match that trailer to this hitch design if it doesn't have that style of ball or size. Easier for me to work on. Plus, when you get free trailers, it usually means there's something wrong with them. There's a reason they're free. They could have broken wheels, axles, whatever the case. If you keep those spare parts, now you can fix the ones that you get for free to be usable in the race, or have spare parts when you race one. Somebody blows the axle off your trailer and you still have a good frame, you shove another axle under it and you're good to go. So in my mind, it's surprising to me how many of the actual racers do not keep their trailers or anything when the race is over and they just toss them to let go. This is going to be something where if enough people start doing this, all of the free trailers in the surrounding area are going to be gobbled up very fast for people wanting to race them, especially when you have a trailer get destroyed every single race. But there you guys have it. That's just my mindset. I'm going to cut this thing apart, get this car out of here into storage, and keep cleaning up the shop. I want to get as much room as I can for the oncoming winter as it approaches. Look how open the shop is right now, guys. I can't remember the last time we've seen this much room in here. Incredible. I can see my floor again. That's typical though, during the middle of build season, you know how it goes, it's always a mess. So what I like to do at the end of build season, I will go around and take all of my tools, all my parts, everything that's just thrown on the floor, laying on the top of trunk lids, on shelves, clean everything up, put it back where it belongs, 100%, all of it exactly where it should be. That's the way when I get busy again with a rush build or something last minute, I know exactly where to find it. A lot of guys leave stuff laying around all year round in your shop, and over time it just accumulates into a headache and you stress yourself out and you waste more time when building your car because you can't find what you're looking for. So yes, it may take me a couple days to redo and sort everything correctly, but it's going to save me a lot of time in the long run. So that's what's going on next as I clean up stuff around here, get ready for the incoming snow season. And we'll see what else we can dig into for this year. I don't know if we've talked about this yet, guys. I may have teased it previously when we talked about the van. I have something else you guys still haven't seen on camera. There's another vehicle sitting back in the woods that we acquired way back in the middle of this summer, if I remember right. Just have not put it on camera yet because I knew it would not be used this year. So stay tuned. We'll eventually get into that thing as well.